and I'm just sitting here thinking about all of the money that I could be getting right now. Wasting my time with you, when I told you I only got top of these bitches I count. I only come through for the guarantees. Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Do not mind my buns, y'all. I just don't care. Today we are back for part two of things that annoy me. If you haven't seen the first one, you should go check it out. That was my last video, but for anybody watching the future, I'm gonna link it in the description box. Before we get started, make sure that y'all like, comment, and subscribe. I always forget to say it at the beginning. Comment down below, let me know what annoys y'all, like what's your little pet peeves, or let me know like if some of the things that I listed annoys you too, or if they don't annoy you, let me know why they don't annoy you. Like, let's have some conversation, okay? My little bun just falling apart. Anyways, we go get started with like the straight to the point things first. I don't know why I didn't think of this one for the first video, because honestly, this is probably like the top thing that annoys me. Fucking haters. Like, I cannot stand a hater. Like, why are you so insecure and miserable? Like, that's pathetic and it's sad. Like, you're mad at other people's accomplishments, how other people look, like how other people get treated by others. Like, that is just crazy and insane to me. It's wild. But what made me think about this one, y'all, I was scrolling on Facebook and I came across this post, or this reel, and this woman was like doing like a little vlog, like her morning with like five kids or something like that. And I like watching mom content because it's so cute to me. Like, I love kids and I want to have kids one day. So when I be seeing like little mom content, I be watching it. But anyway, yeah, so she was doing like her little morning, showing her morning with her kids, right? And she had a nice house. She had, you know, some nice little things or whatever. And I go to the comments, you know, because I just like going to the comments. I like to see what other people got to say. So I go to the comments, y'all. Why did somebody say, you know what, let me go look so I can say verbatim what they said. Because I screenshotted it. Oh my god, y'all, I forgot what the comment even said. The comment said, so this is just to show off the fact that your husband makes the money and you get to stay at home. Like, what? Like, that's some hating ass shit. Like, okay, like, first of all, this is just her morning. Who's to say she ain't got a job, first of all? Like, bitch. That's what get me too. Like, I cannot stand when people just get to assuming shit. Like, I mean, and guilty, like guilty. Like, I might assume some things every now and then, but if I assume some things, I'm gonna do it up here. You know what I mean? Like, if I have an assumption about something, but I don't really know what's going on, I'm gonna keep it to myself. Like, that's one thing. This is like off topic. This ain't got nothing to do with something that annoy me, but everything don't need to be said. Like, everything that you think in your head does not need to be said. Like, some things you can keep it to yourself, okay? Keep it to yourself. Like, that just shows like your insecurity. Like, so she can't show her morning routine because she might be a stay-at-home mom and it may seem like she's bragging, baby. Just say you a hater. Like, just say you a hater. Like, if you can't stay at home, if you gotta go to work but you don't want to, well, that's your fault. That's your fault. Like, that's your fault. If you want to be a stay-at-home mom, then you should have got a man with some money. I don't know what to tell you. Like, I don't understand. Like, what's your point? Like, what's your point? And if she is a stay-at-home mom, your coming ain't finna make no difference. She's still finna be at home taking care of them five kids while her husband make their money. And I don't see nothing wrong with that. Like, I might as well follow up with this next one. People who don't mind their business. You need to mind your fucking business. Like that person in that comment, you don't know if she got a job or not. She just showing you her morning routine. Mind your fucking business. Like, and most of the time, people who are haters mind other people's business. So if you mind other people's business, well, I ain't gonna say this. Because you can mind other people's business but not be a hater. You could just be messy. But you just need to mind your fucking business. Like, I swear you will live longer if you mind your fucking business. Mind your fucking business. Like, I don't get it. Like, you being in somebody else's business is doing what for you? what is it doing for you? Like, I just don't get it. Like, I could care less. Like, I really could care less. And maybe it's just me. I don't know. I don't have energy to be paying attention to what everybody else is doing, what everybody else got going on. Like, I just don't give a fuck. Like, if I'm not your friend, if I'm not dating you, like, if I'm not learning something from you, like, what am I minding your business for? Like, it does nothing for you. It does nothing. The next thing I got on my list is people who claim they don't like a person but won't stay out their face. Ain't no way you over here telling me that you don't like this person, but every time I turn around, y'all are talking. Because I'm going to just assume you're fake. Like, I'm going to just assume you're a fake ass bitch. Like, and I'm talking about, like, in work environments mostly. If y'all watch my channel, like, if you a subscriber, y'all already know, like, most of my little situations and feelings I get about situations come from the people I've experienced in the work environment. I don't like most people. Like, I really don't like most people. But to lessen my stress at work and just to keep my cool and keep my job, if a person speaks to me, I'll speak back to them, even if I don't like them. But I'm not about to go out of my way to start a conversation with you. I'm not finna tell you good morning. I'm not finna say shit to you if I don't like you. And that's how you gonna know I don't like you. I'm not gonna say shit to you, period. But yeah, like, cause it's this one lady in my job. I don't like her. And I don't like my boss either. But she says that she don't like the boss, and she be talking like mad shit about this lady, but she's always in her face, always talking to her. They buy lunch together. Like, she'll get on DoorDash or something and they'll order their lunch together. I'm like, bitch, that's your bestie. Like, so why are you over here acting like you don't like this lady? Because ain't no way I'm finna be doing all that with a person that I claim I don't like. Ain't no way. No, if you don't like somebody, don't fuck with them. Like, so simple. And since I'm talking about work, let me go ahead and get to my next point. People who take jobs in, like, upper management positions and things like that, like HR, management, supervisors, leads, all that stuff, just so they can feel powerful. Ooh, that irritates me so bad, y'all. Like, most people who are, like, CEOs, managers, and things like that, like people in, like, upper level positions, most of the time are just assholes. Like, they are assholes. And I think it's just pathetic. Like, you have to get in this position to feel like you got authority and power and control over other people, or just to, like, just to, yeah, pretty much just to be in control of people. Or to just be an asshole and not have to really face the consequences. Because if we being for real, y'all, most of the time if you're at these jobs and you try to, like, speak up about something, a lot of the time, don't shit get done. Like, and I know from personal experience, nothing gets done a lot of the time. Especially because, I don't know if I put this in the last video. I'm pretty sure I talked about it in the last video. I know I did. But passive aggressive behavior, a lot of times people do passive aggressive things that you can't go on foul and prove. Like, you can't, like, you don't really have proof of, oh, John's an asshole or Christina is an asshole, she's a bitch. Like, you really can't prove that, okay, they just said this to me, or they did, like, you know, like, you can't really prove that type of stuff. But I think it's just really pathetic that people get in those positions just so they can have this authority and just abuse their power. Like, it's really just lame as fuck. You're a fucking loser. Like, anybody watching this that's ever done that, you're a fucking loser. I think sometimes too, a lot of people are bullied in their younger days, so, like, they grow up and then they become the bullier. And it's just like, babe, you would have done better taking the other route. You would have done better taking the other route. Like, and I talked about this on my second channel when I was talking about forgiveness. Y'all need to watch that video. That's one of my favorite videos I made. It's so good. But becoming, like, the people that you despise, that you resent, that you hold anger for, that made you feel bad, how does that make you, like, that does not make you better. Like, that doesn't make you a better person. It does not make you a better person. This shit is just ridiculous. It's ridiculous. Like, how do you not look in the mirror and be like, damn, I am a literal reflection of the people that I claim to hate? Anyway. God. Okay, so this next topic that, well, this next thing that annoys me. I thought about this when people were talking about Jada and Will. I watched like a couple YouTubers that like was talking about their situation. Don't ask me what happened, y'all. I barely even remember. But I know it was something like Jada and Will's like hasn't been together for like 7 years or something. Like they've been separated or something and blah blah blah, yada 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 yada. I don't care. I just watch the YouTubers because I like them. I like you. It's certain YouTubers that I watch where I really don't care what they talking about. I'm just gonna watch their video because they're funny. I like their personality, you know, like that type of vibe. But a couple of the people that I was watching had some interesting views, I should say. They were like saying that people were basically like glorifying their relationship because they stuck together and they haven't left each other and, you know, whatever. And, you know, basically glorifying the quantity, you know, the length of their relationship and the fact that they're not leaving each other over the quality. And I don't know them people personally, y'all. Like I said, they just an example for the thing that annoy me. The thing that annoy me is when people glorify the amount of time people have been together versus the quality of people's relationships. It's really pathetic. And I feel like a lot of people like grew up believing that, oh, like if you've been married for 15, 20, 30 years, like that's just like so great and so amazing, when most people are in terrible relationships. Like most people are in toxic relationships. A lot of people getting cheated on. Ooh, my battery's dying. A lot of people are getting cheated on left and right, up, down, round, around. Some people are getting abused mentally, physically. Like these relationships do not be nothing to look up to. Like they don't be nothing to look up to. Yeah, that's what annoys me. This next thing that annoys me, y'all, is something so like irrelevant, really. But it just annoys me. So I watch like some people do like TV show reviews and like movie reviews and stuff like that, and they would give a disclaimer at the beginning of the video that there's gonna be spoilers in the video. And that annoys me. Not the people who give the disclaimers, kind of, I'm getting to that, but it's the fact that people have to get on here and tell y'all there's gonna be spoilers in a TV show review. Like, why are y'all so fucking stupid? Like, why are y'all so dumb? Like, if you're clicking on a video and you see the title is like, because I've watched like Love is Blind reviews. I've never watched not one season of Love is Blind, but I be watching them reviews, y'all. Like, I don't know why. It's entertaining. But yeah, so I'll be watching like Love is Blind. Oh wait, that's what I was gonna say. I'm on disconnect. But if I click on a video and it's a Love is Blind season 5 episode 1-3 review, and it's a fucking 45-minute video, you're not gonna assume that the video is literally what it says. It's a fucking review of the show. Like, that's so, like, I mean, like, what do people, y'all don't think. I was gonna say, what do people think? Y'all don't think. And that's the problem. Y'all don't think. And you know what? Some people do think about shit. Some people just like to be fucking annoying. And that's irritating too. People who like to just be fucking annoying and trolling, and you need to grow the fuck up. You need to grow up. You need to get you some business about yourself. Because why? What's your point? That really annoys me that they be like coming on their videos having to give those disclaimers. Like, this is an hour long video. You don't think there's spoilers in this? Okay, anyway. Y'all, speaking of like YouTube, another thing that annoys me And this ain't even just YouTube. This is like any platform, really. When you post a fully detailed video and people get in their comments asking you shit that you know you talked about in the video, why even click on the video if you was not gonna watch the video? Like, if you wasn't gonna, like, I'm telling y'all, like, okay, for example, if I post a video dyeing my hair, right? In the beginning of the video, like, you, I'm gonna have my little intro, then I'm gonna show what products I'm using. I'm using this, I'm using this developer, blah, blah, blah. You did not even watch 2 minutes of the video to see what hair color I use. Why are you just gonna come and be like, what number developer did you use? Bitch, like, I'm not gonna respond. Like, 9 times out of 10, you're not getting a response. Like, because that's fucking annoying. Like, bitch, I put my time into making this video, trying to help you out. I put my time, my effort into making this video, editing this video, posting this video, for you to come and ask me shit that is in the video. That's so fucking annoying. Okay, y'all, so the next thing that annoys me is men that wants to be pursued. Men that want to be chased like they a woman. That's like so, that ain't even annoying to me, really. That's more so just like cringe to me. Like, it makes, like, you like come across like you want to be a woman. Why? Like, that is what I think. Like, and it's a difference between, like, you have a man who don't mind if a woman shoots her shot, you know, like, I'm like, okay, like, she came up to me, you know, like, I thought she was good, you know. You know, like, a man who's, like, not against a woman shooting her shot versus a man who's literally sitting around waiting and wanting to be pursued by women. No, sir. Like, get your ass up. I get so sick of these spam calls, y'all interrupting my video. But, yeah, take your ass over there and stay over there. Like, stay far, far away from me. If you're a man and you want to be pursued, like, I'm not finna ask you on, I don't know, I don't even recommend shooting your shot. Like, I don't agree with that. Like, I'm not about to ask you on no date, and like, I'm sure not gonna pay. Like, what? Like, I feel like if I go pursuing a man, I go ask him out, like, you gonna think I'm paying for the date? Like, if I ever shot my shot at a man and I like wanted to ask him to go out, I would ask him, do he want to take me out? Because I ain't finna take, like, no. Like, I need you to know that you're gonna pay for this date. But yeah, I don't know. I've talked about this on my second channel, but I'm gonna talk about it a little bit right here. Like, I don't think women should shoot their shot because, like, now you're, like, the initiator of the relationship. I think that's weird, and I think that's, like, reverse. And, I mean, that's just me personally. Like, if y'all wanna do that, that's fine. Like, I don't care. Like, again, I'm gonna mind my business. Like, you can do what you want. But for me personally, I'm not doing it. Like, it's not happening. No. Mm-mm. I got one more thing that annoys me, but I kind of really want to go on a rant about that, so I think I'm gonna just make that one a separate video. I also kind of got a story time to tell with that, so I think I just make that a separate video. Yeah, I'll just make that a separate video. But those are things that annoys me, y'all. When I think of some other stuff that irritates me, I'll come back with a part 3. But yeah, once again, y'all, make sure that y'all like, comment, and subscribe. And I ain't really got nothing else to say. So, bye.
Hello?